We can see that, you know, some of these have 37K a month, 22K a month with only one review. Step by step, how to sell on Amazon FBA this year, plus some very important updates that literally have happened in the past few months, and why it's so critical that you understand what these are so that you actually have a chance at being successful at one of the best ways to make money online, which of course is Amazon FBA. Quick note, I'm not going to be selling you anything in this video. Literally, you couldn't even buy anything if you wanted to. There's zero courses for sale. There's none of that stuff whatsoever, because the truth is you don't have to spend money learning Amazon FBA. You can watch videos just like this, and you can learn pretty much everything that you need to learn to actually be successful doing this. And we're gonna show you everything that you actually need from A to Z in our beginner tutorial guide in this video to show you exactly what you need to do to actually have success with this strategy. And as a final note, this is a beginner's guide. So if you are a complete beginner, if you've never even heard of Amazon FBA before, first of all, welcome to the channel. But just letting you know that this is gonna be the perfect video for you, because this is more so for beginners. So what I recommend you do is sit back, relax, maybe take a couple of notes during the video and get everything that you need to go from a beginner to an expert on Amazon FBA all in one video. If you don't believe me, stay tuned and I'll prove it. So we're gonna split this video up into a few critical parts. The first part being what to expect from Amazon FBA. Amazon FBA is obviously not a get rich quick scheme. It takes time and energy to deal with suppliers, to actually order samples of your product, to order your product, to actually have it shipped over to the USA so that it's actually available to be sold. Now, does it take, you know, years and years? Of course not. It takes, you know, a couple of months, but it does take time and energy, and it does take some money to get started. We'll talk about how much a little bit later on. But the best way to approach Amazon FBA is one of two ways. Either you go all in, or you approach it as a side hustle like I did when I actually still used to have my full-time job back at Facebook. And so what I suggest is taking Amazon the way that it should be taken, as a real long-term business. And if you treat it like that, and you understand that it takes work and time and energy and blood, sweat, and tears like any other entrepreneurial venture or startup, then you're gonna have the right expectations going in. Now, part two, the difference between FBA and FBM. Now, FBA is fulfilled by Amazon. FBM is fulfilled by merchant. What's the difference? Fulfilled by merchant means that you ship it from your own house, for example. Fulfilled by Amazon means that Amazon ships it from one of their warehouses. Now, if you buy on Amazon like I do and basically everyone else in the world, you probably have realized that a lot of products are Prime eligible, meaning that they arrive in 2 days. What that means is it's fulfilled by Amazon. It's sitting in one of Amazon's warehouses. I myself generally only buy things that are Prime eligible, which means, of course, that it's a huge advantage actually having that Prime eligibility, meaning that you ship all of your products directly from your supplier into an Amazon warehouse. You never have to touch them or see them yourself, and they're eligible for 2-day shipping, where Amazon handles all of the logistics, the fulfillment, the picking, the packing. You know, they have the website, they collect the money, and they give you your cut of everything when it's all said and done. Generally, we shoot for about a 30% profit margin, give or take, depending on what particular category you're interested in. Now, part three we're gonna get into right now, and this is one of the most important parts. Part three is how to find home run potential winning products, right? The most important thing in all of Amazon is finding products that have the highest possible chance of being successful. And so what I'm gonna do is jump into my screen and show you a few tips and tricks how you can find incredibly profitable and unbelievable potential products in just a couple of clicks. But before I do, if you're enjoying this video, do me two quick favors, please. You don't have to if you don't want, but I would appreciate it if you just tack the like button for the YouTube algorithm, and also commented down below on this video, Amazon FBA tutorial. Those three words, Amazon FBA tutorial. And if we get 1,000 likes and 500 comments that say Amazon FBA tutorial, then we are going to release a part two of this video where we go into a lot more detail and share a lot of templates that you can copy and paste and a bunch of fun, exciting stuff. Oh, and PS, also somewhere in this video, I'm gonna be teaching you how you can actually get on a completely free one-on-one call with an Amazon FBA expert who can teach you one-on-one live on a video call how to do product research like the pros. And I know that sounds crazy, but I'm gonna show you guys exactly how you can do that, again, completely for free. So make sure you don't go anywhere. you don't skip around the video or you might miss it. All right guys, so welcome into my screen. So this is a tool called Zonbase. Now there are, you know, three or so different large Amazon software service providers. You know, there's Jungle Scout, there's Helium 10, there's Zonbase, right? I choose Zonbase because Zonbase has the best customer service. They have the best accuracy when it comes to product research, actually using product research tools. They have the most accurate database when it comes to keyword research, and they have a lot of services that are offered that the other two corporate companies don't have. And so if you're looking more so for a startup that has the best customer service, the best accuracy, and the most tools, then Zonbase makes a lot of sense. And even better, you can actually try Zonbase completely for free during your free trial, which means that it's zero risk and you can play around with a really powerful tool. And who knows, maybe it's the first step to actually creating your Amazon empire. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna use a tool called Zon Research. Now, Zon Research is a really powerful tool. We're gonna click keyword here because keywords give you an overall landscape of the products that you're actually interested in. We're gonna press select a preset here and we're gonna click base hit. Now, what this does is it pre-selects profitable categories on Amazon, because Amazon sells everything, which means they have a lot of different categories. You can't really make money on Amazon if you sell a product that's less than $13, right? And you don't really want to sell a product on Amazon that has more than 100 reviews, which is why it automatically input these minimums and maximums. The one thing that we're going to do is we're going to raise up this average monthly revenue to 50K, right? Between 9 and 50,000. Anything more than 50,000 generally has too much competition. Anything less than 9,000 generally isn't worth our time. And so with all of these different filters selected, what Zonbase is gonna do is they're gonna go out and they're gonna search through tens of millions of products to find products that meet these criteria that we set, right? And so what we're gonna do is we're going to actually click on some of these, right? There's a lot of really good stuff. Outdoor swing for adults, tandem kayak, you know, water table for kids, vanity stool, Roblox party supplies, which is great, scuba tanks, solar mole repellent, right? All sorts of different things here. And so what we're gonna do is just open up some of these just to take a quick look at these. Stainless steel shelf, makeup set, garden shears, right? A lot of really interesting stuff. So, you know, I tend to stay away from things that are, have, you know, pointy objects like that, because, you know, you just don't know what you're going to deal with. But you can see that Zonbase actually found 4,634 entries for that filter, which is pretty incredible if you ask me. So the next thing that we're going to do is find a couple more things. Maybe let's try scaffolding. Let's also take a look at maybe one other thing like yurt tent. So once we actually have these opened, we can see that, you know, there's a lot of different options here. Some of them are, you know, expensive, some of them are not as much so. We're gonna run what's called the Zonbase Chrome extension, right? What this allows us to do is it allows us to actually see in real time the real numbers from Amazon related to these products. So we can see that these yurt tents are selling, you know, 14,000, 18,000 a month, 75,000 a month, 21,000 a month with zero reviews. So this is a really interesting product for people that want yurt tents, right? Let's take a look at this other one here. So this is scaffolding. You know, again, these are pretty high priced products, you know, over $100. Let's run the Zonbase Chrome extension here and see what we see. It gives us average monthly revenue, it gives us average monthly units sold, it gives us average unit price, average reviews, right? Really, you know, beautiful stuff here. We can see that some of these have a, you know, a high price, but again, some of these are a little bit too low, right? Only 3,000 a month, 3,000 a month. So we're gonna close this one out. It doesn't really meet the criteria we're looking for, between 9 and 50K on average. So we're gonna look at the Wake surfboard, right? We can see again, these are, you know, higher priced items, which, you know, I definitely like and don't necessarily shy away from. We can see that, you know, some of these have 37K a month, 22K a month with only one review. So again, this is something that we would look at. Right, and so what we're gonna do is we're going to actually keep both of these open, yurt tents and Wake surfboard, and then we're going to move into part four. Part four deals with how to actually find these products and get them manufactured, obviously for a much steeper discount than what we're gonna ultimately sell them for on Amazon. This is the same business model that Walmart uses. They buy in bulk for cheap and they sell individually for a significant markup, right? So we're gonna go to Alibaba.com and we're actually going to type in Wake surfboard. right? And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna change it where it says products. We're actually going to put suppliers and click search, so you don't have to, you know, see the same multiple products offered from the same supplier. Rather, you see individual suppliers. Now, what we can see is there's a lot of different companies here. We like to see the companies that are old, right? 17 years old, that do a significant amount of revenue, right? Some of these are doing 10 to 50 million, right? And so I like the ones that are doing more revenue, especially ones that have a lot of presence in North America. You know, 9 years is old enough. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna click this supplier. And so what we're gonna do is we're gonna actually go to products here, and we're going to type in surfboard. And we can see that they have a lot of different options here, right? They have some stuff as cheap as $80 per unit. They have some stuff, you know, 100 or even more than that. And so what we're gonna do is compare their average price, which seems to be somewhere between, you know, $100 and $200 or $130, right? $120, right? So generally about $150 here to what they're actually selling on Amazon. So we can see that on Amazon, you know, they're generally selling for about $400, you know, $450, $250, $430, right? So we can buy it on Alibaba for, you know, $150, and we're selling it on Amazon for $300, $400, $450, or even more, right? And so then what we wanna do is we wanna actually understand, you know, what we could actually make from a profit margin. So to do that, we're gonna type in FBA calculator. We're gonna go to the FBA calculator here, and we are going to actually take this product. Let's just take one of these products here. You know, we'll take maybe this one right here. We'll click on this little handy dandy ASIN, and we're gonna come in and we're gonna click right there, right? And what did I just grab? I just grabbed the unique identifier that says what this product is in all of Amazon's catalog, right? It always appears after the DP right here in the URL. I pasted it in here, and then this actually populates that exact product, right? So if we see that they sell it for $449.99, so if we put $449.99, we're gonna estimate that this costs, you know, maybe $30 per unit to ship to Amazon, and we're going to, you know, on average estimate that it costs about $150 for the product. How did we get that, right? We just looked at, you know, the company right here, and it generally seems to average between $100 and $150 for these products. And what we're gonna do is click calculate. Now, what we see is after Amazon's fulfillment fees and shipping fees and cost of goods, it's a 39% profit margin. Now, is this perfect? No, absolutely not. But it is a good idea, right? Because you get an average cost from Alibaba where you can buy it in bulk. You know, you approximate the shipping. Generally, shipping is, you know, anywhere from 20 to 50% of the actual cost, you know, of the product itself. And so if we take, you know, 20% here, you know, multiply this by 5 is 150. So 20% is 30, which gives us, you know, a 39% profit margin, which is something that we would like to see. Now, in section number 5, we're going to be talking about samples and how to actually initiate your order. Well, the way that you do that is you actually will open up communication with the supplier by clicking contact supplier, right? You'll ask them what their minimum order quantity is, or MOQ. They'll tell you, hey, you know, you have to order 100 units to get this cheap cost. And you say, okay, I'll get 100 units for $130 each, right? I know that I can likely sell them for, you know, $450 each, get them shipped over, and you can start selling them on Amazon. Now, that's of course simplified, but, you know, one of the things that I recommend most of my students do is get a sample. Once you've actually finalized what product you want to sell, you have your supplier ship you directly one sample of this product. Now, you know, if it's a big, bulky, or, you know, a prohibitively expensive product, you can always do, you know, a video call and really, you know, inspect it very carefully and do it that way. Sometimes you want to hold it in your hand. It really depends on you, right? So you can order a sample from them, so, you know, it makes it seem like you really know what you're talking about, asking about a sample or at least a video call. And then once it comes time to actually order, generally what you do is you put down a 30% deposit. So let's say that the total cost was, you know, $10,000, just for the ease of math. You would put down a 30% deposit, or $3K, and then they would create all of your products for you. You'd actually get what's called a third party inspection company, right, which you can find very easily on Google for very cheap. They would come and they would check your products over in China at the manufacturer. And then once they give you the green light and say you're good to go, right, then and only then you would pay the 70% balance. Your transaction with the supplier would be done, and then you'd actually work on getting those products shipped over directly to an Amazon warehouse. Now, how do you actually ship those products? Well, it's called a freight forwarder. Now, freight forwarders are the companies that transport all sorts of products all around the world, and there's many different options. One of the options that I like to use is called Freightos, which is spelled like this down below. It'll also be featured in the description, but there's many different options of freight forwarding companies that you can use that are incredible, affordable, and will get the job done from point A to point B. Part five is you actually have to create your Amazon listing. Now, if we go back to Amazon, we can see that this product doesn't have a very good listing, right? They barely have anything here, right? Their title is not particularly interesting as well. An example that I like to use is binoculars for bird watching, right? So there's a lot of really good listings here to learn from. So you can see that these people have, you know, a lot of keywords stuffed into here. Binoculars for adults, universal phone adapter, super bright, large view binoculars for bird watching, hunting, sports, waterproof. All things that they know people want for this particular product. If we come down here, you can see the same thing, right? They have all sorts of keyword rich, things in here, how big the eyepiece is, right? Prism lenses, more light, right? Binoculars for adults, right? All sorts of things that they know people are actually searching for to find these particular products. Now, how do you find what words people are searching for when they're trying to find your product? Well, you find that, again, using the number one software for Amazon. So if we came in here, we went back to the dashboard in our free trial, right? And we actually clicked on keywords, right? What we can do is we can actually type in binoculars for bird watching and click search. Now, what it's gonna do is it's gonna show us, you know, the Google trend score for this. It's gonna show us how many times people are searching it every month. It's gonna show us similar words to binoculars for bird watching here in the word cloud, right? It's gonna really give us all of the information that we need to ultimately be successful, listing this product, creating a listing that Amazon likes, that's SEO ready, right? Search engine optimization, that's really gonna show and appear in front of the most possible customers that would ultimately want to buy our product. And so if we scroll down here, we can see binoculars for adults has, you know, tens of thousands of searches, binoculars for kids, binoculars for bird watching has 28,000, right? So there's a lot of different keyword volume here that people are searching every month. So we'd feel very comfortable about, you know, populating our listing with all of these keywords to make sure that we were attracting all of the customers that wanted to ultimately buy our product. And so you wanna make sure that you have all of the highest searched keywords inside of your listing. And you can use the listings that are actually appearing in Amazon for your particular product to learn a lot about what types of listings actually work for Amazon's algorithm. And the way by which you do that is looking at awesome examples of similar products that are already selling for a product that you're interested in launching yourself. And the last part of actually being successful on Amazon is getting reviews, launching your product, and getting sales. Now, getting reviews is best actually to use Amazon's service called the Amazon Early Reviewer Program. It's a service that costs $60 and you can get five first reviews for your brand new product. Amazon actually endorses this. It's the one way that they actually allow people to do this, and it's the best way by far to get your first reviews. Now, why do you need reviews? Because when you actually go to launch your product, just think about it for yourself. Would you buy a product on Amazon that had zero reviews? Because I wouldn't, right? So you need those critical first five reviews using the Amazon Early Reviewer Program so that you can actually launch your product, get it to page one, and actually start using PPC to even boost your sales further. Now, if you don't want to go and learn, you know, PPC and launching all by yourself, again, you can use the number one Amazon software suite in the world to do this for you, right? You can see right here by clicking on page one, Zonbase will actually go and launch your product for you, get it to page one for you. And when I say get it to page one, I mean literally on the first page results for the keyword that you know customers are searching that they'll ultimately want to buy your product. So for example, if they search binoculars for bird watching and you were selling binoculars for bird watching, you'd want to be on page one so that customers saw your product, right? Zonbase will do this for you. It's very, very difficult to do for yourself, which is why it's so incredibly valuable that Zonbase actually handles this for you. Now, last but not least, there is PPC, which is marketing. This is a way where you can pay $1 for marketing to get $2 of profit, right? And additional sales you wouldn't have otherwise had. What this means is, and I'll show you guys exactly what I mean, Let's say that we search binoculars for bird watching, we can see that there's something called a sponsored post, right? That means that this person is actually paying, you know, $1, $2 every time somebody clicks on their listing when they search this keyword, right? Now, PPC is a little bit more complicated than I can get into in this particular video, but again, if you don't wanna learn it yourself, right, Zonbase has a done-for-you service called PPC Autopilot, where they'll actually use machine learning and artificial intelligence to do your PPC better than any human could do it. Now, I know I've said a lot in this video, and again, if you're enjoying it, make sure you click the like button and comment down below Amazon FBA tutorial. If we get 1,000 likes and 500 comments, we'll actually release a brand new video we've never talked about before. But the moral of the story here, guys, is 95% of being successful on Amazon comes down to one thing, and that one thing is picking the right product. Now, that's why for the first time ever, we actually created an opportunity where you can talk one-on-one on a live video call with one of our Amazon experts on our team, and they will literally teach you product research completely for free. And if you don't believe me, click the first link down in the description and in the pinned comment and sign up for a call yourself. You can actually get on a completely free call with an Amazon expert who's going to teach you one-on-one on a video call how to do the most important part of being successful on Amazon, which is finding a home run potential product. But the one catch is we do have an extremely limited number of these calls available. So if you're interested in Amazon and you want to start an online business and you really want to blow things up this year, then click that link down below and schedule your completely free Amazon FBA product research strategy call with an expert member of our team. And again, if you enjoyed this video, like, comment, and make sure you subscribe and turn on the notification bells. And if you want to watch more videos just like this one here on my YouTube channel, then make sure you actually stay tuned for a brand new playlist that's coming to you live in 3, 2, 1. Click the playlist in the middle of the screen, guys. See you there. Click it. Come on, click it. Do it. Click the playlist. Okay, you don't have to, but I promise you'll like it. Click the playlist. See you soon. Peace.